So my name is Dr. David Kellerman. I'm a lecturer at UNSW. I'm an engineer, I'm an educator, but I'm also a passionate technologist as well. As educators, we're not just teaching our students, for example, how to be mechatronic engineers or aerospace engineers. We're also teaching them to be professionals. Part of a standard syllabus is to do with professional communication and ethics and all of these other things. But today we're also looking at things like modern collaboration. A platform like Teams, something that's cross-platform, it is on mobile, it's on desktop, it's on iOS, it's on Android, it doesn't matter. It's in our pocket, it's on our computer, and it allows us to communicate anywhere and anytime. So you add the combination together, take away monotonous tasks, and foster the valuable parts of that educational experience, like communication. That's what we're trying to do. It's not just about Teams, it's about the ecosystem of cognitive service of Office 365 components that allow us to pull away other parts of the tasks using bots and machine learning and other kinds of things. We're using bots to facilitate communication. So one example would be, a student is on Teams, they ask a question, and funnily enough, my bot is called Question. So they say, hey, I have a question about this particular problem, I'm stuck, can anybody help? Well, the first thing that that bot does is it looks up which tutorial group that student is in, and it looks up who the tutor is for that specific group, and that student is in that group, and it sends a push notification. Now that tutor, bit off goes their phone, one of their students has asked a question, and they might just go bang bang, answer it straight away within a minute or two. Now that's really engaging, but also what's interesting about that is we used a cognitive service, we used an AI platform in order to connect humans together rather than to pull them apart. Now another example is to do with data-driven learning. So I have a huge data set about all of the engagement interactions of my students. And across the course of a semester, I can use machine learning, and I do, to train that model about what kind of student behaviors result in what sort of outcomes. Now, by week 3 or 4 of the semester, I can predict with about 85% certainty whether or not the student is going to fail the course. I have the opportunity to personally reach out. So 500 students gets turned into 12 at-risk students. We've used AI and machine learning to predict who they are, and then me as a course convener, as a lecturer, can reach out individually to each one of those people. It makes a real difference to one person, to one career trajectory. And again, we are having a personal experience, and AI is allowing us to do something that's really humanistic. By the time we get to the end of the semester, but before we get to the final exams, I can predict every student's, not their exam mark, but their mark in every individual exam question. I can use that algorithmically using cloud services to produce a personal, optimized study pack for every single one of my students. And that gets uploaded to SharePoint with individual access rights, and it becomes a tab pinned in Teams. We can provide our students with these data-driven, personalized resources that are going to help them to navigate their way through their studies. What we're working on is not just doing that within a course, but using a data lake across the entire university, across all of those students and all of those interactions to get more and more powerful predictive. And again, what is the purpose of all of this data? It's to help the students, it's to add value to their educational experience.